Hey guys, it's Joe. I hope everyone's doing great out there. Coming at you tonight with a haul video. And this is just some stuff that I have picked up over the week. And it's a little bit of a smaller haul, but felt it was some really cool stuff that you guys would enjoy. So, actually, mainly non-horror. I got one horror thing. The other couple things are non-horror related. The first thing I gotta show is something super awesome, I think, anyway. If you guys don't know already, I am a huge Dick Tracy fan. So my sister ended up finding these and I was absolutely ecstatic when she showed me these. These are, guys, pretty old school, probably when the movie first came out, Dick Tracy dolls. So if you guys aren't familiar with Dick Tracy, it is a fantastic movie, guys. And I really can't say, I think it's one of the better comic book movies that has ever been made. You know, I mean, not superhero, but I'm talking like comic book, like movies. It was one of the best ones they've ever done. Ahead of its time, honestly, I think. And I absolutely love that movie. I grew up with it. I have a lot of nostalgia for it. So anytime I can find anything Dick Tracy, I grab it. If you guys remember, in my older videos, I had my Dick Tracy stand up. I still got it. I was fortunate enough to meet William Forsythe, who played Flat Top and stuff like that. But I'm just a huge Dick Tracy fan. So without still rambling on here, we got Itchy from Dick Tracy here. These are like really cool looking figures there. Pretty good detail on the face. I didn't really delve too deep into these dolls looking for you know, dates or anything on them, but I would assume they came out when the movie first came out there. So we got Itchy, we have Prune Face, which is super cool. Great detail on the Prune Face here. It looks, you know, these dolls look just like they did in the movies. Very accurate. You know, they're wearing, you know, real fabric clothing, which is very nice. Very nice detailed dolls here. So we got Itchy, we got Prune Face, we have Flat Top, of course, who I was fortunate enough to meet the actor, William Forsythe, who played him, and he signed my Dick Tracy standee. But another very cool figure here. We get the Prune Face doll. Very awesome. Unfortunately, Dick Tracy was not one of the ones that was found. But lastly, another great character, Breathless Mahoney, who was played by Madonna right there. So very awesome figure there. Really nicely done, these dolls. I don't know when they're made. I'm guessing early 90s when the movie was released. I'll have to find if they made a Dick Tracy one. I would assume they did. These are the only four that were found for me. But four very awesome dolls right here. Get them all in one shot here. But very cool. Awesome dolls right there. So love me some Dick Tracy. The next item, guys, is another awesome item. I know a lot of people, especially people like big into Funko and stuff, have been looking for this, and it is the Walmart exclusive glow-in-the-dark Batman vs. Superman set there. Now, I'm not going to take these out of the box just because it's sealed, and I know that this is quickly becoming what it seems like a pretty highly sought after item here, and I kind of wish I picked up a couple more for Pete. I know people are out there looking for them, so I wish I grabbed a couple more so I could have you know, helped some people out. But I was able to snag one, and very happy with that. I'm a sucker for anything glow in the dark, so when I saw that they had this, I was like, oh, I gotta grab that. I love anything that glows in the dark. I think is really cool. And I actually haven't really tested these out to see if they glow really well, but I mean, it looks like they do anyway, the way they made them green and everything like that. So very awesome item right there. Very cool. Now the last item is the item I'm most excited about, and I actually haven't even unboxed it yet. So we're also gonna get an unboxing and review in this haul video as well. Now, I originally saw this on Facebook, and then Johnny Taez was talking it up and stuff, and I absolutely had to have this. You guys know I am a Big fan of the reaction line. Now, this is not a reaction figure. This was done by, if I can say the name right, Amok or Amok Time Toys, who also did the Critter. If you guys saw it in one of my previous videos, they did an awesome Critter replica for, like, really cheap. And that thing is badass. If you guys did not see that, go back. You'll find it on this channel. But they do some awesome stuff. And they did an amazing, you know, it's to make it look like, you know, a reaction figure. The old Kenner toys, of course. But they did an amazing figure here. And it is a Herbert West reanimator figure. It is, their line is called Monstars. I don't think they make any more of these that I'm familiar with anyway, but wow, this thing is friggin' awesome. You know, I'm guessing it's made by, you know, Amok Time Toys. But very awesome. The box on this is absolutely killer. I mean, this is way better than any of the reaction figures that Funko has done. This thing is detailed. One of the more detailed ones for sure here. We'll get nice and close there. You get a nice view of Herbert West there. It comes with, of course, the head and his green serum syringe there. Super awesome right there. This card is amazing. Absolutely love this card. Great image there of Herbert West. And then the back here, you got another good picture of Herbert West there. Reanimator. Herbert West has a very good head on his shoulders and another in a dish on his desk. So that is super awesome. And then, which is really cool, it on the very bottom here, it says, thanks to Jeffrey Combs, Stuart Gordon, Barbara Crampton, H.P. Lovecraft, David Gale. So, very awesomely done here. I mean, this thing was done fantastic. Just amazing. Absolutely love this. It will go with all my other reaction figures. It's nice, you know, Funko would never make a reanimated reaction figure just because it's not a popular horror property. You know, hardcore horror fans, Reanimator is a classic. But, you know, to Funko, it is not a popular enough franchise for them to ever make a reaction figure. So when I saw this, I had to jump on it and had to get it. And I hope that this company continues to make more lesser, franchised reaction figures. I would love to see those made. Obviously, with licensing issues, who knows what they can and cannot make. But obviously, they were able to get licensing on Reanimator because this cover, this card and everything is absolutely amazing. So yeah, that is it, guys. That is my quick little haul I got. Let me know what your favorite item was. It was a really good haul, I think, for a small haul. Those Dick Tracy figures were amazing. That glow-in-the-dark Batman, amazing. And that Reanimator figure, badass. So let me know what your favorite one was tonight, guys. And that is it. So I hope everyone has a great night, and we'll see you all real soon.